Well, hello. In today's lesson, we're going to be learning about something called for loops, which is not Fruity Loops, for loops. It's actually something that's incredibly important and an amazingly powerful thing to use in computer science. Basically, what a for loop does is it runs a block of code over and over and over again very, very quickly. Remember, computers are really good at running code very quickly because they can do millions upon millions of calculations every second. So let's say you wanted to draw, let's say 10,000 stars, right, on your P5 sketch. You wouldn't want to have to actually code each and every star. What you'd want to do is just have a loop generate all 10,000 of them, and you can do that in like 3 lines of code or less. So what we're going to be learning about is that. How do we run a certain piece of code over and over and over again so we can like make these really cool, fun sketches? So let's talk about a for loop. A for loop starts like this. You say the word for, and then you have to pass in 3 things. All right. The first thing you do is you tell the computer a starting number. What number do you want the loop to start at? So we're going to say I equals 0. Now, just to be clear, I is a variable name, and you can call that anything. You could say cat equals 0. But by convention, people usually use I. I equals 0. So that's your starting place. The next thing you're going to do is tell it where to end. So I want it to go from 0, and then what's your ending number? I say until I is less than 400. Now what that says is keep start at 0 and keep doing this thing until the variable I gets to 400. Once it's greater than 400, stop doing it. Now the way it's going to get greater than 400 is you're going to increment it. So what we're going to say is I plus equals 20. And the third thing you put in is what you want to increment by, or how much you want to increase by every single time. So just to tell you, once again, a for loop has 3 things: the starting number, the ending value, and how much you want to go up by each time. And a good way to show you kind of how this works is as follows. I want you to look at this. I'm going to console log, which means I'm going to make it show up here what I is. So I want to console log I for you. Move this for 1 second, and I want you to see this. So right now what we've told is we told the computer we want I to start at 0, we want to keep going until it reaches 400 and go up by 20 each time. I want to show you what happens when I press play. Here's the console and I'm logging it. And you'll see here that what the computer did was it printed out 0 or console log 0, 20, 40, 60, 80, so on and so forth until it got to 380, right? Because it kept going until I was less than 400. Let's say I did 10 here. Let's say I said this, 10. You'll see now it goes 0, 10, 20, and it goes all the way up to 390, which is less than 400. Let's say I made this 200. You'll see that once again, now it goes up by 10, but it keeps going until the number is less than 200. So that's basically what a loop does. And just to kind of give you the way it works is that it starts at 0, right? It checks to see if that's greater than 200. If it's not, it's going to run this code, and then it increases it by 10. So then it goes to 10, it checks to see if it's less than 200. If it is, it goes to 20, and so on and so forth. So once it gets to 200, it checks to see if 200 is less than 200. It's not, it doesn't run the code, it shuts down. Now, how can we use this to do interesting things? Well, the first thing we could do is use it to kind of make a bunch of circles show up on the screen. So what I could do is this. I'm going to start at 0, and we go to 400, which is the width of the screen. And what I'm going to do is make an ellipse like this. I'm going to say I, 200, and then 50. And I want you to see what happens. You see all these circles that go across the screen? What happened is that it made a circle at 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, like the x variable, 50, 60, 70, 80, so on and so forth. So it kept making circles all the way across the screen until it got to 400, and then it's like, nah, I'm done. I can make the width bigger. Let's say I made that 100. See, now I'm going to get a bunch of bigger circles. Now I have bigger circles. I can make them start higher. So I'm going to make the y variable a little bit higher. I can make it lower. And you see, that's just it. You could have all these kind of different crazy things going on here. And just to experiment so we really understand it, remember, this is the starting value. What if I change the starting value to 200? What do you think would happen? Well, that's right. It would start around the middle of the screen, right? Because it's going to start at 200 and go to 400. So now when I press play, it starts at 200 and goes to 400. make that back to zero. What if I ended it at 200? So I start at zero and go to 200. What would happen? That's right. It starts at zero and it goes all the way to 200 and stops there. Okay? You can have fun with these kind of things. And let's try this last one. Once you change how much it goes up by. So lens, if I made this like 30. See, now they spread out, right? So it's like 0, 30, 60, 90. They go more far apart from each other. I can do it every 100. See, I only get four circles. 0, 100, 200, 300. 400 doesn't do. Or you could just do one and you get a ton of little circles. Let's see. Kind of just looks like a black line. Maybe we could do two so you can see a little bit of gaps there. Yeah. So you get, now I'm getting tons of circles over there. So that's one loop that we can do. Now we could also do, we don't have to have them go across the screen like that. Once we want to make them vertical. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use another for loop here. So I'm going to say for I equals zero and start at zero again. I is less than 400. I plus equals, I don't know, let's do 20 for this one. And let's say instead of making it go across the screen horizontally, we did it vertically. What we could do is this. We could say, well, let's do a rectangle. We're going to make a rectangle that goes all the way down. We're going to do 200. So the X position is always 200. That the second number will be I. So the I will, so Y variable goes 0, 20, 40, 60. Let's do 50 for that one. And see, now we're going to get a rectangle that goes down the screen. Right? Because it's, now it's the Y position that's increasing. The X is always 200. And we can give those colors. We want to give it a color like blue. We can add that in there. And that's it. So, that's today's lesson. That was it. For loops. Super cool. Super powerful. You can make some really crazy sketches with it. That's all I wanted to talk about today. All right. Have a good day.